One of the strongest earthquake storms, if not the strongest earthquake storm in the recorded history of a specific Italian volcano, is currently ongoing at a complex that produced one of the planet's largest explosive eruptions in the last million years. This is occurring at the Campi Flegrei Volcano right west of Naples, and as you can see, tens of thousands of people live within sections of its vast caldera and volcanic craters which dot the landscape. Some of these people went on to make social media claims that the government was downplaying the severity of the issue by claiming that several magnitude 5 range earthquakes which struck were actually magnitude 3.9. So, is this social media claim true, and is there a legitimate reason to panic? To this, I say absolutely not and no. The Campi Flegrei volcano is not about to erupt, nor is it even getting close to an eruption. While Campi Flegrei is showing some signs of unrest, and the fairly predictable 5-step cycle Campi Flegrei seems to undergo, we are merely in step 3 and are likely to remain there for multiple decades at a minimum, a period of heightened ground deformation where an eruption is highly, highly unlikely. I would only be concerned about an eruption becoming possible if ground deformation for more than 12 months exceeded 2 meters a year, like last witnessed in 1537 to 1538, where some areas reportedly rose by as much as 9.1 meters or 30 feet a year. For reference, the ground only rose by 17 centimeters during the last year. As for the earthquakes, the maximum quakes which struck really were only magnitude 3.9, but, and this is the part that's important, some people that lived adjacent to or right above its epicenter really did feel ground motion more typical of a magnitude 5 range earthquake. Confused? Well, when an earthquake wave passes through different rock units and materials, they do not move in the same way. Any materials or rocks which are quite solid and dense will cause a seismic wave to speed up and have a lower amplitude wave, while anything not too solid such as sediments or lightweight such as clay minerals causes the seismic wave to slow down and increase in amplitude, meaning anything built on the latter will experience far stronger ground shaking. And this is exactly what occurred here when a magnitude 3.9 quake struck just before midnight local time on February 16, 2025, and since it struck in close proximity to the Solfatara site where abundant harder rock since its formation 3,800 years ago has experienced hydrothermal alteration and been replaced with less dense clay minerals such as smectite and amorphous silica. Due to a number of variables, an earthquake can create oscillations in low, medium, or high frequencies, with each corresponding to causing the most significant damage in a structure of a specific height. This is known as building resonance. In the case of the 3.9 quake, its most significant energy was at about 2.3 Hz, which would most affect approximately 3-story buildings. This happens to be about the same height as many regional structures, hence the amplified shaking felt within them. The source of all these earthquakes is an intrusion of magma which has been ongoing since at least 2011 beneath the Solfatara site, where magma has been slowly ascending from 8 to 3 kilometers depth, from which it then expands into a laccolith-like sill that displaces and domes overlying rock. Since there is significant heat present above the magma chamber, underground hydrothermal fluids are heated and expand in volume, which causes adjacent faults to slip, generating swarms of earthquakes. The number of earthquakes which occur is largely linked to the rate of ground deformation at the time. Since the earthquake swarm began on February 16th, the ground has risen by 1 centimeter, which, if it holds, translates to a rate of uplift of 91.3 centimeters or 35.9 inches a year. However, despite seemingly representing a large figure, this is not concerning to me. Similar episodes of elevated uplift have occurred 3 times since 2020, and each of these quickly ended in 8 to 18 days time, returning to more typical rates of uplift afterwards, meaning the same thing will almost certainly occur here. Besides, uplift, which at Campi Flegrei is known as Brady's seism, can reach incredibly high levels without triggering an eruption due to its voluminous magma chamber, which, during the Holocene epoch, has caused the ground to rise and subside at times by as much as 30 meters or 98 feet in the long term. Also, more significant episodes of uplift, even if the 91.3 centimeter a year rate does hold, occurred during 1982 to 1985, and that didn't result in a volcanic eruption either. As a final note, I would like to thank my patron, the Harkman, for upgrading their membership tier to this channel.